Programming of WSKB is provided by Westfield Bank. For more than 160 years, Westfield Bank has been an important community presence and commercial leader in the Pioneer Valley. With convenient full banking services in Westfield, West Springfield, East Longmeadow, Agawam, Feeding Hills, Springfield, Southwick, as well as Enfield and Granby, Connecticut, visit us on the web at westfieldbank.org.
Join us every Thursday morning
from 6 until at least 7:30.
Check out the Bobby G and Company Show
right here on WSKB 89.5.
Community Radio
89.5 WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 at 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
You think you know me?
Folks, we're back. Different day, different time, different life.
Gotta make a new logo for your show, the Joe Didi Show.
Oh, what's the logo look like?
I don't know. We're gonna have graphic arts do a logo for you.
Oh, wonderful! Nice. I'm excited.
You like your new opening theme music?
Yeah. That's
If you listen to the lyrics, it's very fitting.
Yeah. There's a lot of things fitting lately, but we won't get into that today. We're gonna behave. Not like last night, and we should be good. I'm very fortunate today. I have a young woman who apparently I knew for a long time, but I just didn't know it. Here, Cindy Sullivan from the Senior Center. We have her for a half hour, and we're going to talk about the aging population of Southwick. Nothing personal, Mr. Fox, but that's where he's headed. How old do you have to be, Cindy? Like, I'm 57.
60.
Whew, I got three more years. Three more years before I can actually walk in there and get my $2 meal.
Yes.
Yeah, and bitch about everything like everyone else does.
Yep. Yeah. Well, you don't have to be 60 to do that.
Oh,
but.
That's good. What about the poker tournaments? I hear there's some heavy poker tournaments.
Tuesdays and Thursdays. It's cards.
And I do appreciate you bringing those old timers back because they did torture me at one time.
I'm sure. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. And I enjoyed it.
They're very happy to be back.
Yeah, they are. And it's you're fully open now, correct?
Yeah, we've been fully open for almost a year.
And actually, you were open through the whole pandemic.
We
put tents up. You guys, you rocked it 110%.
Yeah.
Your lunches kept going.
Yep.
It really wasn't a hiccup other than no one was allowed in the building.
They weren't allowed in the building, so we brought as much as we could out.
Yeah. Yeah. Very good job, too.
We did classes. We did crafts.
Yep.
We did meet the select board. We did all kinds of stuff.
I think we call that hangman. Yeah. But anyways. Back in the day. So you were technically part-time back then?
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Yeah, yep. Right. So, you know, we have a part-time director making everything happen over there.
Mm-hmm.
And you got a great staff.
Yeah, with the help of my staff.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it always comes down, you know.
I had a lot of helpers.
We can be as good as we are, but at the end of the day, behind the scenes, it's everyone else that makes us look good.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and that'll never change. Yeah.
That's important.
It very much so is. Mm-hmm. So what's new on the agenda? Are we dancing? What are we doing? Singing with the stars? Singing with the selectmen?
Yeah.
I hear Doug's got a hell of a voice.
Yeah,
that's what I heard.
That's a good one. I'll have to put that.
Yeah. Doug Moglen. I think he's on the third Wednesday. I don't know if he's wearing his tutu yet, but he looks pretty good. Let me tell you.
Well, I'll have to keep that in mind. I'll have him sign up first.
So how does it work? Do you have to be a resident of Southwick to go?
You do not have to be a resident of Southwick. We actually have a lot of the seniors can go anywhere.
Okay.
So we get a lot.
Anywhere in town hall or just anywhere?
They can go to any senior center.
Oh, gotcha. They have a special card, like they show the badge.
Yeah, we have to register.
They have to have a cane, or
they
is
don't
it
have
no
to have a cane?
No cane.
Nope.
Velcro sneakers only.
Maybe.
Maybe
that helps.
That does.
Yeah.
Okay.
It helps. So we have a lot of residents from Westfield, Agawam, West Springfield, and our seniors also go to other senior centers.
Nice.
It's just what's offered. So yeah. Right now we have classes every day. We've been doing in-person classes since September.
Okay.
And we only had to close down for like 2 days because of COVID. We have lunch every day. We're still doing grab and go, and we have in-person lunch. And people really like to come in, but then they also like that McDonald's, you know, can
drive through.
Many people are taking care of loved ones at home,
yes.
So they can just get out and get their meal and go home, or they just don't want to come in.
Right.
So it's nice that the state has allowed that to continue.
It is.
So, and then we plan, we have crafts, we have bingo, we have all kinds of stuff.
Every
it's
day.
Very big.
5 days a
every
week.
Every day.
Weekends
five
are closed.
Days a week. Fridays is a little slower.
Quiet. Yeah.
But we do have chair yoga in the morning and
nice.
People can still come in for lunch, but by Friday afternoon
we're done.
It's pretty quiet, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So new and exciting things over there. Painting
so,
class, what I mean,
well we're planning
how
our
to park
summer
your car
activities.
In between the lines.
Yeah, we don't do that. No.
Oh, all right.
Wow.
I know. So we're planning our summer activities. So we have Benson's Barbecue coming up in a couple weeks.
Nice. Where's that held at?
That is going to be at Wally Park.
Okay.
We did it in 2019 and haven't been able to do it since.
Nice.
The fire department hosts that. They pay for it.
Nice.
But this year, the Benson family, Roy and Marlene Benson, were very active in the senior center. Roy was a board member for many years.
Many years.
Unfortunately, he was a veteran that passed away at the soldier's home right in the beginning of the pandemic. And his family wanted to honor them in some way. So they're actually paying for a lot of, they're kind of sponsoring
Good.
The event. So we called it Benson's Barbecue.
Sure.
It used to just be a hoedown. Now it's called Benson's Barbecue. So, and his family's going to be there, and it will be really nice.
Seniors in a hoedown. I can't picture that.
It was
that, but
fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. We dress up. There's going to be a live horse. We're going to have hay.
A jackass or a horse?
It'll be a horse.
It'll be a horse. Okay.
Yeah. It could go either way.
I didn't know if Russ was going or not. So.
Did you get volunteered for that?
No. Not yet. Not that I'm aware of. Could be a drive-by, though. You never know.
Yep. Jack and his guitar will be there performing.
Nice.
And the line dancers love it because they do line dancing and everyone gets up and dances. And it's rain or shine. In 2019, it rained.
Right.
And the fire department still cooked all of the food in the pouring rain. And
that's awesome.
It was amazing. The relationship that we have with police and fire at the senior center, it's amazing. I can't complain about it.
It's come a long way. I mean,
yeah.
Nothing against past seniors or folks mm-hmm. that ran fire police, but you've seemed to... Force them, maybe, is a nice way to say it, but
you've made
everyone merge together and actually work together nicely.
Well, I think it's giving people opportunities to do things. Everyone wants to help. They just don't know how.
True. Very true.
And then, you know, Russ Anderson coming on when he was hired, he was like, let's do the sign program.
Yeah.
Let's do the buckets.
And he had parents that were aging out, too. So he was,
you
know, involved whether he wanted to be or not.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, Russ has done a lot for this town that, you know, how do you say it? There's a lot of unsung heroes that don't need the
mm-hmm.
publicity behind what they do.
Yeah.
But they do it.
But they do it for the seniors, and it's just, I can't complain about it. The select board as well is very supportive. So we're very lucky. I don't complain too much.
You do complain quite a bit.
Not a lot, but
publicly, which is good. That's part of the process,
right.
You know?
Right.
You're supposed to be able to vent a little bit.
Yeah.
Nobody's perfect.
Absolutely.
You know, especially dealing with town government.
Yeah.
Nothing's easy.
Yes.
Nothing.
The processes are very slow.
They're very slow.
But I'm familiar with that, so.
You are.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, at town hall, or fortunately, we do get some, you know, some great blood that comes through there that are just not used to town government as a whole.
Yes.
And it's extremely frustrating. Mm-hmm. 9 years ago when I went in there, I had my guns loaded. And I did fine because I don't care. You know, I believe in what I believe in.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're a little shy and... You just, or how do you say this? If you come from the private sector, it blows your mind.
Yes, it's
you
very
know,
different.
The wheels don't turn in town
they go
government.
Slow? Yes.
On a good day.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you've managed to, you've gone through all that. There's no issues. You've learned budgets mean something. You got to be 3 years out. You know, we laugh at budget season when we look at everything and we're worried about today.
But, you know, if you actually turn the page, there's your 2-year, 3-year, 4-year programming sitting there, which we don't look at because we can't afford what we're doing now, of course.
Exactly.
You know, but it's all good.
Exactly. But you have to project. You have to think about what the senior center is going to look like. And, we've really grown a lot. I'm very proud of that. I've been here for almost 9 years now. In July, it'll be 9 years.
Yeah.
So I'm very proud of the fact that we've grown the senior center, the programming that we do, how we deliver services.
Yep. But technology too is,
technology has helped. Yep.
It's helped quite a bit, especially during COVID. You were able to do a lot.
Yes.
You know. Yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely. So we're open. We love being there, and so that's on the 22nd. Anyone can sign up. We have almost 100 people already signed up, so we'll have to cut it off pretty soon.
And the age limit for that?
60 and over.
60 and over.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
So I'll project out 3 years on my calendar.
Yeah. There you go. You can come in 3 years.
Okay.
That's awesome. Bring the horse.
I got plenty of jackasses around. Yeah. There's no doubt about it.
Mr. Moglen's bringing the hay.
Is he?
It's supposed to be straw.
So he's probably picking it up from me. Hay. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
That's wonderful.
And then we're bringing back the senior sizzler at the town beach. That'll be August 2nd.
That's what I was thinking of. So that's, okay.
So we are bringing that back. That has been missing for a couple of years.
Yes.
So we'll be putting the call out for assistance for cooking for that.
Hmm.
But the seniors love that. It's at the town beach. Again, we'll have Jack and his guitar playing, hamburgers and hot dogs, and all of that is free.
That's wonderful.
So, but they do have to sign up in advance.
Speaking of the town beach, what time is it? Are we going to have 15 minutes? Perfect. So whether you liked it or not, you've seemed to have merged, into also Park and Rec.
Yes.
What are your thoughts?
It's a new role. It's happening.
It's very, it's 90% my fault, and I apologize every time I see you.
It's happening, and it's okay. It's just,
It's a lot.
It's very different than the Council on Aging.
Yeah.
The politics are very different.
Yes,
the
they
Council
are.
Council on Aging. And just the processes, it's a lot.
It is.
Park and Rec is a lot in Southwick. We have a beautiful park, Wally Park, and we have a town beach.
I mean,
a lot of communities don't have both of those things. And we're fortunate to have the rec center. They do a lot of the programming.
They do,
which is fantastic. But it's the everyday stuff of Park and Rec that people don't really realize. And Kara did it, you know, on her own for a lot of years, and she was amazing.
And it's interesting.
So is the programming similar to the senior center? Like you're doing programs in spaces, but you have more land to manage now.
So what part of my new responsibilities are programming. So it's scheduling the ball fields, it's scheduling the soccer field, and I also applied for 3 cultural grants.
Right.
And got all 3 of them, so we have a series of programs for kids over the summer. So that's something that people just didn't have time to do because it was always managing the parks.
Some small towns and cities actually have a park and rec department.
Yes.
With full-time staffing, mowing, everything else.
Yeah.
We don't. We have some great facilities.
We do.
But we don't have the infrastructure to really maintain them properly.
Yep.
And by merging and by torturing you to do these dual roles. But we needed to because you needed to have a department head in charge of park and rec.
I agree.
We did not have that.
Yeah.
The young lady, what was her? I can't always forget.
Kara.
Kara. Yep. I don't want to get yelled at tomorrow on the paper. Kara. See, I said it right. Way over her head, and we tortured her. That poor lady had to do everything.
And
she's a little church mouse, and she was quiet about it, and she did it.
Yeah.
So
she was amazing. Yeah.
Yeah. It really. She's done a hell of a job for the town. And you wouldn't know it because she's not out front.
She was quiet about it. Yeah.
Yeah.
And she only worked 18 hours a week.
There you go.
And she did all of that. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm sure she worked 25. We only paid her for 18.
Yeah. Yep.
The Southwick way.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
But no, a hell of a lady did a lot for this town and still does because I'm happy. You're not. But we were able to merge her and morph her into almost like an assistant for you.
Yeah, she is an assistant.
And you're in a team now.
Yep.
And what a difference. You don't maybe see it.
It's amazing.
You know, day to day at Wally Park, but, you know, now you have somewhat of a ground screw there to do some of that maintenance. We had it before, but no direction.
Mm-hmm.
Not that directions are always perfect, but at least, I'll be honest with you, at least now at 4 a.m., not my problem anymore, when a tree falls, it gets somewhere.
Yeah.
Where before it went to a voicemail.
Right.
You know, and 3 days later, social media tortured you that a tree fallen on the rail trail.
Yep.
So we've come a long way.
Mm-hmm.
And we're not done.
Right.
You know, you still need a lot of money over there, and you still need more improvements that you're going to show somebody next year on what you want.
Yeah.
And it's all good. I mean, the park was built probably 9 years ago, too,
mm-hmm.
I would think.
Yeah, it's when a I came beautiful in, it was park. There. It's just, and people should be there.
Yes.
People should access it.
Yes.
But we need to make sure that it's maintained.
Yeah, and it's
and
safe.
And that we have programming
yeah.
and that it's safe. So we also have a new AED there that was donated by the Kevs Foundation.
Yes.
And we're getting one for the town beach as well. That's
wonderful.
Presentation is happening in a couple weeks. So, you know, we're very fortunate to have that. And that just, it adds that layer of safety. And
it does.
We're really appreciative of the Kevs
Foundation.
With
the athletic fields
that.
And everything mm-hmm. that's there, you know, that should have been thought of years ago. But once again, you know.
But you don't think of those little things when you're always putting out fires.
Yeah.
So the restructuring it this way, we're able to think about those things.
Yeah, and it's wonderful.
Yeah. Yep. And the fields look beautiful. And
you guys are doing a great job. Everyone involved.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. You know, you're scheduling stuff. I'm not thrilled every time I drive by and see the lights on. But, you know, eventually we'll get that, you know, electricity deal figured out because monies are just, it's just crazy to turn
it
a light on today.
Very expensive, which a lot of residents of Southwick don't really understand.
At they all.
Everyone wants their kids playing at Wally Park.
Yes.
And we do too.
Yeah.
But it costs about $1,400 a month
yeah.
to turn those lights on for one set of lights. If you have two on at the same time, that's an additional demand charge. So
yeah, it's
very
crazy.
Expensive. But yeah. David Sutton is working on a plan for that. So.
Oh, yeah. No, we'll get there. We'll definitely get there.
We're trying, but ultimately we have to charge people because they
you
have
do.
To help us pay for it because we don't have.
Most people don't understand there are costs involved with everything.
Exactly, because there's not costs everywhere, but there is when Eversource is definitely has their process.
They do.
Yes.
Yes, they do.
And we have to follow it no matter what.
And there are no discounts.
Correct.
No discounts. And yeah, how many ways do you spend?
Not even with our gas and electric in Westfield, there are no discounts.
Right.
Yeah. It's just the way that it is, and we have to deal with it. And parents sometimes say, well, why can't we play at Wally Park? You can. But the school department also has their fields.
Yes.
And I would love for, you know, Wally to be the home field for softball and baseball,
sure,
and even soccer if you know if it could work out, but it will cost money.
Yeah, no matter where they go, it
no
costs
matter
money.
Where, right?
Right, even in there, mm-hmm. you know, and it's nice. The park's beautiful. Yes, we added the lights, so you want to play under the lights.
Yeah.
So yes, there's everything has a cost, like you said. You know,
they do.
The high school fields are beautiful too. They work well, but there's no lighting, and the kids want that whole experience nowadays.
Right. They want to play at night.
Yeah,
parents want them to play at night because
they
want to.
They can be there
to the games.
Yeah. Sure, no, it's a win-win.
So we're working on it, and I hopefully we'll get there. Maybe do some fundraising to raise, you know, just money for the lights. But it's about almost $20,000 a year just to run the lights.
Isn't that something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If we were to turn them on every single month, so we try not to do that.
Right.
Actually, that's just from April to October. That doesn't include. That's not 12 months a year.
Right. Correct.
But we don't do that because we can't.
No, you just don't. The funding's not there. Yeah. We go round and round. Yep. Thank God. You know, you have Rugged Maniac. You have the motocross. You have events that you guys generate money from parking.
Yes.
But it's still not enough.
Right.
Because that's got places to go too.
Right.
You know, fertilizer. I mean, it doesn't end.
It does not.
Nope. You know, and you have no budget.
Right.
Not to be mean, but you just don't.
Yeah.
You know, it's the stepchild.
Mm-hmm.
It's always been the stepchild park and rec.
Yeah.
And, well, we tried, of course, to hopefully change that somewhat moving forward because, you know.
Yeah, I think we're working on it.
Oh, you're doing great.
Kara is fabulous. I'm teaching her COA, and she's teaching me park and rec, and it's been great most of the time.
It is. You know, there's a lot of personalities involved. And,
there is a lot of personalities, yep.
And some of us just aren't good at things. I'll just say it like that. You know, in a good way.
Yep.
Nothing wrong with that.
Sure.
All right, so that's good. So we got that taken care of. You have your rec center, park and rec. Fundraiser golf tournament this year. You're thinking about it? You guys are talking a little bit about a golf tournament at one point? Out the window.
Yeah, I don't know about a golf tournament.
Okay.
We've talked about maybe doing a craft fair or pocketbook bingo.
Pocketbook.
You know, something
is that where you
like
bring
that.
A wine bottle? What's the pocketbook bingo?
Pocketbook bingo is it's very popular. It actually was started in Westfield with the Westfield Foundation. It wasn't started there, but we brought it from the Midwest.
Sure.
a foundation that was started, the Westfield Foundation for Education, kind of brought pocketbook bingo to this area, and now everyone wants to do it.
Joe, so it's highly competitive. These women almost get fist fights over bingo calls.
It is very competitive. You get 100 or 200 women in the same room going after a Michael Kors or, you know, a Coach pocketbook, and it can get serious. It's a lot of fun.
Wow.
But it's a lot of planning, and again, it's just trying to figure that out and getting the Park and Rec Commission want to do more.
Sure.
Again, they need to know what to do. So yeah. that is helpful. It will be helpful.
Yeah, because that's interesting. You actually work with two different boards, right? Because the Senior Center has a board.
Yep.
And then Park and Rec has a board.
Yeah, I think I have the most bosses in the town of Southwick right now.
You know what?
Pretty sure I do.
Pretty sure. We'll have to look into that.
I think I do.
Carl Steinhardt, when you have time, can you call me?
Hey, Joe, the equivalent for guys for pocketbook bingo is if you guys were all playing for a big block engine.
No.
Yeah, oh
no,
yeah.
No, it's not. No. We don't have those issues.
It's a fun, you can raise a lot of money. You need a big venue to do it in.
Yeah.
And it does take a lot of planning, but it's something we're talking about. It's not anything
definite. No, understood. Yeah, winter's coming.
But it's anything that can defray the cost of the park and rec expenses.
Yes, which when you do that, you raise money parking cars, that all stays in park and rec.
It does.
Doesn't go through the town. It's literally your funding to help with your situation. Yep. And can you donate to park and rec?
You can. You can just
write
a
revolving
check
account
to,
for that. Yeah.
To the park and rec.
To help with lighting or whatever
Absolutely.
You might see.
Anybody can. And you can donate to the COA as well, same way.
Right.
People are generous with the COA too. So
well, they are. You know, you hold a lot of hands over there in those older years that a lot of children aren't doing.
Yeah, they can't. They can't.
As I recall, if you don't pick up your lunch or take it off the door by a certain time, Cindy Sullivan calls the police, and then the police come. No, you're right on top of it, though. No one's, you know.
We have to make sure they're okay.
Yeah. Yeah, no one seems to fall through the cracks, I should say. I mean, it happens, I'm sure, but, you know, you don't let me volunteer anymore. But that's okay.
We won't talk about that, Joe.
Yeah.
Giving meals to people who aren't supposed to get them could be a
I didn't know,
reason.
Okay? And I went and bought meals to replace the meals I gave away.
I know you did. I know you did.
So I didn't have to tell her. But then they told her. Yeah. So I got ratted out.
Yeah, that was one thing we did during the pandemic was everyone who came into the senior center, mostly by van and could not come to the grab and go, we changed our whole operation and started delivering all of those meals to people. So if you could drive through, great.
Yep.
If you were on Meals on Wheels, even better. But if you're in that gray area, there's always a gray area, we just delivered the meals to you.
Yeah,
so
did a great job.
It was great that our drivers did it, our staff did it, you helped
once.
then we used your strengths in other ways.
Yes, you did. And I appreciate that. Yeah, I'm better off behind the scenes, not trying to figure out an address.
Right, yep.
Yeah,
yep.
That was embarrassing as all heck.
It was funny.
Yeah, it was funny. And you got to laugh.
We laugh.
You have to laugh in this
hysterical.
World.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a way with people.
Yeah, it was great.
All right, so what else? Nothing. Wintertime's coming. You got nothing planned over there? Nothing decent?
Summer, you mean?
You guys, no, winter's we're already
winter's
past summer.
Like
no.
Fall preview.
So in the fall, our classes end at the end of June.
Oh.
Our exercise classes do. We're trying to get back into pre-pandemic mode where we had classes from September to June.
Gotcha.
Because that's what the budget allowed.
Right.
So, and a lot of people go away in July and August.
They do.
Our instructors want some time off.
Sure.
So they can still come in, but they pay their instructor directly, and it's not every single week.
Gotcha.
So that will start back up in September every week. We were able, it's only $2 to take a class at our senior center. Because it's supplemented through, we have a line item in the town budget.
Yep.
I use my formula grant, and I have a classes account that all of that $2 goes into. So $2 times how many people, it can add up. So they used to be $3 or $4. Now they're all $2.
Nice.
So, and our classes are packed. They're full. People love them. And we're happy to do it.
How does the senior bus work? I know Russ was trying to get another van for you guys, a small van.
Yep.
I'm not quite sure where that's.
I have a fleet.
You're going to have a okay, so it is moving forward.
Yeah, it is moving forward. Hopefully awesome. It'll be approved. So we have the FRTA van.
He said he was going to put his face on a sign.
Yeah, he's going to drive it too. Oh, he's going to be the first volunteer we call.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the FRT van.
Yep. The FRTA van is the paid van that people come in for lunch.
Yep.
They can go to medical appointments in Springfield. We have a schedule that kind of that's through the FRTA in Greenfield.
Right.
But Denise does all of the scheduling for that. And, well, Denise does most of it. We do some of it. But
yeah, understood.
Denise definitely
yeah, that's
is
her
a
world.
Rock star at that.
Yeah.
And then we have our volunteer van, that we call it the volunteer van, that's in the garage. That's the town of Southwick. We got that through a grant.
That's bumper one, I call it, right?
Yep,
that's
the bumper one. Yep. Bumper one. So that is driven by our volunteers. And it takes people on trips. We do a lot of trips. I didn't even talk about the trips.
Yeah.
We do a lot of trips, and it's kind of an overflow van. So if the FRTA van is stuck in Springfield and our lunch people still need to come in, we'll call a volunteer in to drive that. The third vehicle that we're looking at is more of an SUV. It's a smaller vehicle. It would be handicapped accessible for the people who don't want to drive a 15 passenger van.
Correct.
It can be, that can be a lot. We have a 99-year-old lady who comes in probably 3 or 4 times a week. She's amazing, but she can't get into the volunteer van,
right?
Because that first step is too high. So we'll use a town car for that.
Gotcha.
You know, again, very generous with our seniors that we can use the cars that the town has, and we'll go pick her up in that. So this van would be perfect for her.
Absolutely.
It's an SUV, not a van.
No, understood. But it's for the one-offs, for the small stuff.
It is,
A chaser, per se, right? You always needed that third vehicle, more or less, that anyone could drive.
Yeah, people get afraid of driving that van. I drive it.
Yeah.
And I think I'm a great driver. My staff would disagree.
I think they
when
would.
When we were driving around Southwick during COVID, saying hello to everyone.
Yeah.
But that was fun. But not everyone wants to drive it.
Right.
So now this smaller vehicle will allow us to be able to do more of that.
Sure. Plus, I would think errands, and there's always a need for it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Always. And it could possibly be used for our companion program that we started as well.
Wonderful.
Yep.
So companion program, 3 buses. Yeah, I think we're doing okay for a little town of Southwick.
The tax work-off program is starting off.
The what?
The tax work-off program. Those applications.
That's been sitting there for quite a while.
Yep, those applications are available. We've actually had about 7 people pick up applications this year.
Good.
And they can for the next week. And then, you know, I have to do the formula to make sure everyone qualifies. And, you know, they can be placed at the library, the boat ramp, the town clerk's office, the assessor's office. And actually, Kara had somebody at the beach a couple of years.
Nice.
Was that all suspended during COVID?
And in the schools. It was suspended for 1 year in 2019. I tried to do it in 2020. It was very small. The schools were still closed, so it was really hard to find places for them to go. And honestly, the seniors didn't want to be in big crowds.
No.
That was a smarter idea for
them
not
to
be out
there. We didn't have it, not because we didn't do it, but because... The need wasn't there.
Right.
People just didn't want to. The seniors didn't want to.
And it's not a huge tax incentive, but it's something.
It's $1,500.
Oh, is it $1,500? Yeah. I thought it was $500.
So it can be.
Up to $1,500.
Yeah.
Wow, that is a lot.
Yeah, and they get paid every hour is whatever the minimum wage is.
Sure.
So, and I also have some that can volunteer in the senior center.
Nice.
Not all of them. Everyone wants to volunteer in the senior center, but we just don't have the hours to.
Needed to
make it work. Because it's not just putting lunches away. You have to earn it. So you have to earn it.
I'm sure some of them said they could do your job too, but that's beside the point.
Yeah, exactly.
Those are those card players. Yeah.
Yeah,
absolutely. Well, it's great having you on for a quick half hour. I appreciate
it.
Good things to come, right?
Has it been a half hour already?
Yeah.
Wow, amazing. Thank you. I always like to publicize the senior center.
There you go.
And now Park and Rec.
Yeah. So. Well, we appreciate
Thank
your
you.
Time, your effort, and your last 9 years.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hopefully there's another 9 in you.
Yeah.
Thank you. I didn't hear the thank you. Thank you.
Yes. There is.
There was a hesitation there.
There is. Yeah.
Yeah. No, there is. I truly think there is.
Yeah.
Yeah. You've done a lot there. And you know, I think within probably 5 years, we have to look at expanding that senior center anyways.
I agree. We're running out of room.
Yeah.
For sure.
Which is a good thing.
Yes. It's a
great
really
thing. It really is. There's grants. There's formulas out there.
Yep.
There's ways to make that work.
Yep.
It's just a matter of do we go up or do we go elsewhere, right?
Yeah.
That's what it comes down to.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. I love being in the town hall and sort of the scene.
I truly do, too. I think it's a win-win. And when they designed that deal, they designed it for a second floor.
Mm-hmm.
So it wouldn't take much to move those classes upstairs.
Right.
You know, almost like a gymnasium style.
Right.
Take the pressure off of downstairs.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can see that happening.
Yep.
You just need an elevator on your side, though. And we can do that. We'll put one in.
Yeah.
You have that breezeway there on the way out.
We can do that.
I got a guy. I got a guy for that. As long as we can do it at night. Pete,
all right.
Let's take a quick break and we'll come back and me and you will have a talk for a half hour.
Sounds good.
See what you can find. If a daddy's rich, take her out for a meal. If a daddy's poor, just do what you feel. Speed along the lane, you go down or return to 25. When the sun goes down, you can make it good and live by. When I grab people, when I daddy, when I mean, we love everybody, but we do as we please. When the weather's fine, we go fishing or go sailing in the sea. Philosophy. Sing along with us, dee 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 dee, da 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 da, yeah we're happy, da da da, dee da da dee da 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 da, da 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 da,
alright alright alright,
da 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 da, summertime, and we'll sing again. We go driving, or maybe we'll settle down. If she's rich, if she's nice, bring your friends, and we'll all go into town.
Support for Community Radio on WSKB is provided by Betts Plumbing and Heating Supply Company, an independent, family-owned wholesaler serving Westfield for over 50 years, specializing in plumbing, heating, and industrial piping supplies. On the web at BettsPlumbing.com or at 14 Coleman Avenue in Westfield.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Dunkin' Donut Shops of Westfield and the Sardinia family. It's nice to know that even as the world changes, Dunkin' Coffee remains the same at 7 convenient locations throughout Westfield.
I'm Mark Auerbach. Join me every Friday at 8 a.m. for Arts Beat, where you'll meet interesting actors, directors, designers, and musicians here in Western New England.
Community Radio,
89.5 WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
Welcome back, Joe.
Hey, welcome back.
We got to teach you how to do the ins and outs. You did pretty good on throwing it to the break on that one.
I did pretty good at what?
Throwing it to the break.
Throwing it. What's that terminology mean? What do you mean?
I mean, you're throwing it to the underwriter break. The music and the break and
all
that.
Yeah, we normally don't do that. We just talk for an hour.
Well, but, no, I've had you take breaks around the half hour mark.
Yeah. I just figured with her, she was good for a half hour. I didn't want to torture her for an hour. You know, and I do appreciate her coming on.
She loves television.
I've asked her for years, and for years I got the look, right? 7 years we've been playing this game. And I walked in there last week, and I said, hey, any chance? I said, Pete says I got to have someone on, and, you know, we're going
to... It's good to have a guest.
Yes. It really is. It really is. That keeps me out of the newspaper the next day, I'm told. So, you know, which is fine. But now I can say whatever the hell I want. So,
right.
And I will try not to be a jerk most of the time.
So topics I wanted to cover in this half hour.
I have three topics. What do you have?
I want to cover the fireworks civics fun.
Yep, we have that on the agenda.
I want to cover the farm a little bit, and I want to cover drag racing.
Well, I don't have those.
What do you got?
I have fireworks, and then we're going to talk about the war memorial in the center of town, and then I'd like to talk, and I don't care which order, the master plan.
That's fine.
Yeah, the master plan.
I
want to
start
first.
Delving into Joe Didi a little bit.
You don't want to go there.
Yes, I do.
It's a dark, 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 dark side sometimes.
No, it's not.
No, it really isn't.
You want people to think that, but it's not.
It's not. No. No. I'm just as crazy off this deal as I am on this deal.
Yeah, but you're also a very complex individual.
I am. Yeah, I don't know how that happened. It wasn't from college, I can tell you that.
That's called life.
Yeah, life experiences. Yippee-ki-yay.
It's called life.
Yeah. So, master plan.
Yes.
I've been attending a few meetings.
Okay.
I'm the silent one in the back. I take it all in. I spent several years on the planning board, which I truly, truly enjoyed. And they have a different concept this time around. My understanding is years ago when we worked on the master plan, it was 5 or 6 people. They did what they did. They did a good job. Unfortunately, when I went to town meeting, a lot of stuff really never went through. Because no matter how good your master plan is, town meeting still has to approve it in the end. And I believe the last time through, certain segments were, no doubt about it, but not everything. So this time, they put a real neat group of people together from boards, committees, and, you know, Joe Public.
So they did a nice cross-section of the community?
If you could slow down enough to listen at these meetings, and it's also on Zoom, and not be... I guess bias, just, you know, look at the big picture, take a deep, deep breath. They're doing a great job. They have different, all different walks of life. And they're not, they're all good people, but just the way I look at things, from communication people to, I think there's some high school kids on there, to be honest with you. I think there's a teacher or two. It's a great.
They all bring something different to the table.
Absolutely. And with today's technology, you know, 20 years ago, whenever they did the master plan, 25, I don't even know, to be honest with you. It was, you know, so it's shell, it's been written, and that's that. You know, now it's not like that. Technology,
right.
You know, and they're coming up with last night was the last night of hashing out they're doing a survey online. And it's going to take probably 20 minutes, 25 minutes to do, but it's very thorough. And
they need those. You need those what are called data points.
You really do.
As to where people are at, because you don't want to go after something that people are not going to want as a town. And the more people that participate, the more data points you get. You get a better feel for what's going on. If you only get a big small sample, then the silent majority that's always out there and never participates is going to go, whoa, I didn't want that. Well, you need to participate.
Yeah.
It's my biggest thing.
We can talk about that another day. But,
right.
Yeah, and you're absolutely right, Pete. What I think was interesting is some of the verbiage that they're going through. I kind of chuckle because some of it goes back to what the, you know, if you want X kind of project or X kind of, I don't know, cornhole or, you know, bocce ball, you name it, it's still going to go back to the town to get the money to do that.
Right.
So it's not, you know, it's a great vision, I think. I think it's a win-win to see where the youth of this town or the middle, you know, age group of this town.
The demographics.
Yeah, where they want to see it go. So I'm excited about that personally. I can't wait to see how it turns out in the end.
Okay.
But there are some brochures throughout town. I have them at Mulishus. I know they're in the town hall in a couple spots.
I love the fact that they're green and they're keying out.
Yeah, and they did a, you know.
No, look at, hold it up and look at the monitor.
Oh, God. Sorry about that.
That's okay. I think it's, you know, funny.
And she's telling me today. Cindy's like, oh, thank God I didn't wear green. I go, geez, I never got that memo. But I don't think I own anything green. So. But, you know,
I do, but it's a Westfield 350 shirt, courtesy of Harry Rock.
There you go.
I don't wear that in here.
So you won't be able to see it, but they actually made a little character of the jog up, which is cute. They just did a nice job all in all. They're a great group of people that donate so much time to this master plan, and those are long nights. I snuck in at 8 o'clock last night after I had a meeting with the we'll talk about that later. What was it with? Lions Club. But that's another subject.
Okay.
So I get there at 8 o'clock, you know, and I think we left at 9:30, and they started at 7, and I don't know how they stay awake, but they do. And it's thorough. It'll be exciting to see. You'll be able to go online and take that survey. They're going to post throughout town once it's ready. So I think it's probably a month or maybe a month and a half they'll have it out there before they get the tally back of, you know, where do people want to see things go.
That's really cool.
And then they'll form committees on that, and then, you know, that process will get started, and then I would think maybe, and this is me talking, I don't know the logistics, but probably I would say within a year they'll have something to bring forward. So it is exciting.
That's really cool, actually.
Yeah, and it's a town approach. So shame on you if you get up a year from now and complain about an industrial park or another golf course or, you know, an extension of a rail trail because you didn't get involved. You have every opportunity right now to be involved.
I saw that a long time ago in Westfield with the Western Avenue project. I was slightly interested, so I went to a couple of public meetings, and they were pretty well attended, but, you know, it was only maybe 200 people out of a city of 40,000.
Yeah.
And especially in a densely populated area where Western Avenue is.
Yeah.
And you didn't see a lot of people from the college there.
Yep.
Who's directly affected. And then everybody complained when it was already done and everything was settled, and now they're building this thing, and everybody went absolutely wild about it. And I was like, I was there at the beginning, man. I don't know where you were, but too late. That ship has sailed.
Yeah, and that happens everywhere, right? I don't care what it is. You know, that. It's amazing.
By the way, I never got your picture, so.
Oh, I'm so, well, you know what? Technology here, right?
I keep telling you I'll hook you up to the Wi-Fi, but you never take advantage of it.
Yeah, that's the.
Anyways, we could talk about it.
We can talk about it. All right, so that was. That was the master plan, and I maybe the next show I'll get someone on from the master plan committee to talk with me.
Sure.
It'll be someone that can tolerate me, so it's going to be...
You do know you can expand your horizons now that you're, you know, outside of Southwick. If something interests you somewhere else.
You know, the problem with finding hosts from Southwick is...
Or, I mean, like other places around the Pioneer Valley, if you wanted to go on the road and and do something with your business or racing or something personal, like something.
We keep going back to that racing, huh?
Oh, that intrigues me. I've been a racing fan since. Yeah. That's my dad's fault.
So headers are being put on, being built for the car.
Most people don't know you have a drag car.
Yeah.
That is restored with national championship car.
Yeah.
It's a restored national championship car.
It is.
And it's been a quiet little project for you in your garage for a couple of years now.
Well. You make sacrifices in life. So for 9 years, I was a selectman. For 9 years, that car sat on the back burner.
Yep.
As time goes on, things happen in life. Quite honestly, I had a knee surgery done last fall. I'm getting the other one done this fall.
Mm-hmm.
And you start looking at your life a little differently. Like maybe you should slow down a little bit. You know, the candles weren't built to be burnt on both ends.
Sure. I learned that lesson the hard way.
Yeah. And I'm in that process right now. So last fall, I decided to just stop playing around and get this car done. Mm-hmm. And we had a heck of a winter. Chuck Capella out of West Springfield. Debt of gratitude. literally tore this car apart with me, and every nut bolt has been cleaned, redone, you know, grade 8 aircraft specifications all the way through. So the car started to go 6 seconds. I don't know, 190 miles an hour. My mental capacity is started to go probably high sevens, low eights. At about 160, I'll be happy.
Yep.
And that's plenty bang for your buck, because in 7 seconds, there's a lot happening in a quarter of a mile.
So my dad had a very similar story. He was on a national championship modified team.
Yeah.
When he was in his 20s. And then he met my mom and literally walked away from it for years.
Yeah.
For almost 2 decades. Until we were old enough to appreciate it. And then he started going back to the races and got involved with Teddy Heber and Teddy Bear Pools.
Oh, yeah.
And Tommy O'Sullivan and Tommy O'Sullivan Racing.
Yeah.
And got back into it. And then, because we were old enough, we were teenagers by then, or just about teenagers. And we'd go to Riverside Park with our dad. And it was great bonding time with my father.
Oh, yeah.
And stuff I'll always remember.
Yeah. The disease hit me very, very young. My uncle was Ron Zanoli here from Westfield, the only Exxon station by Cantel Supermarket back in the day. So he lost his legs in Vietnam.
Okay.
So I honestly became his legs, right? You know, you're young, you're a little guy. I hung around that gas station. And from there, it just morphed into, you know, he drag raced. He went into service for drag racing because he got caught too many times. So back then, you were either, you know, you went to jail or you went into service. So,
sure, yeah.
So he chose the service. So that disease was always there. My kids, I laugh because growing up, if I wasn't in school, I was drag racing somewhere in New England. So I married my wife, who I met when we crashed, I think, our third car, and I had a month off. I had to get a job at Big Y in Southwick, where I met my future wife. If we didn't crash a car, I never would have met her. And it is what it is. But when he had passed, you know, I ended up with some of the pieces and parts. And it's a disease. It truly is a disease. And whether you have a bass boat habit, or you know who knows what, right? Golfing. Yeah. It's recreation. I get it. It's therapy, but it is a disease. My kids, I got them involved with junior dragsters when they were little. My daughter's got a beautiful 1960 Bel Air today. My son owns a couple race cars and a couple street project trucks. And, you know, they didn't get in trouble right through high school. I mean, that's how I always looked at that.
You kept them on the track instead of in the jail.
Yeah, yeah. You know, no, I went to jail. You know, I've had issues with drag racing. But
there weren't venues back when you were a kid. Now there are more
places to go. There's venues now, but there's an illegal street racing side of me that's starting to come out, too. So. But we'll do that in other states, so yeah, hopefully it doesn't follow me back here.
But, yeah, I terribly miss it. Like, I really wanted this summer, before I go down to Florida, go to Stafford a couple times.
Yeah.
And just kind of go back down there and kind of, you know, I got to talk to the Arute family again, because I had volunteered to do a 360 video of the track.
Oh, there you go.
And I want to get down there and do that before I go. That's one of the things during the middle of the week. I just want to go out and drive the track several laps and just post a 360 video.
Sure.
And have people get that experience of sitting in the track.
Oh, yeah.
You know, yeah. Just put it, you know, got a magnetic mount for the top of my car for my GoPro and just do laps.
Yeah. I think Lebanon Valley had a Musselpalooza last weekend. And
I love Lebanon Valley Speedway.
Yeah. Doug Moglen, you know, reached out probably a month before and said, hey, we got to go. He took his Mustangs up. The chief of police in Granville took his old antique police car down. Ricky Foy brought out his Willys.
Nice.
I took the Ranchero. And, you know me, I get up there. I'm in there 5 minutes in a car. She'll go, nope, we're going racing. Go get the tech card, you know. Like, where's Joe? He's in line to go racing. We got one pass in. But luckily, you know, it's cute because the guy in the end is trying to explain to me, if I have a passenger in the car, I'm going to lose a tenth. And I'm just smiling like, you're clueless of who I am, which is fine. You know, I said, and I finally had to tell him, I usually don't drive slow cars. So,
yeah,
you know, this is a new experience. And it was great because a guy named Jimmy, who works for me, got to ride in the passenger seat of the Ranchero to go down the track. And you know, it's an 18-second car.
Right, yeah.
You know, just banging gears and having fun.
Right.
But the smile on that kid's face, the videotape of that lap, and the whole experience, you know, it's pretty cool that I'm able to do this and still have some fun doing it.
As
you know,
part of my job at Channel 40 back in the day, Jim Klein,
yep,
got to do a series with the Dodge Neon Challenge Series at Lime Rock.
Yep,
back when they had the Neons, and it was an all-star race. So he got invited, his local media, to go and race.
Yeah.
And so they did a couple of track days with the Skip Barber Racing School and the whole bit.
Yep.
And he asked me, because he knew what a racing guy I was. I loved covering. I would tell the assignment desk, I'm going to cover Riverside tonight.
Yep.
You know, and they'd be like, what? I'm going to cover Riverside tonight. And they're like, oh, okay, whatever. So he dragged me down there for that, and we had such a great time doing a series on that. I mean, we did a series for May Sweeps on that, and we just had such a good time doing it. But the Skip Barber guys took me around the track in a two-seater.
Yeah.
And just said, all right, do the best you can with the camera. We're going to go top speed. And we were flying around that track. And it's a lot of fun.
It just is. Yeah. And I'll get off topic for 1 second, then we got to continue.
Yeah, then we got to go back to the veterans.
So my other life, we did ride and drive throughout the country. I did a detailing in the high-end restroom trailers and my other businesses in life did quite a bit. But I got to hang out with all professional race car drivers of all different sports. And what a blast. What a blast, you know.
Stories.
Oh, so I'm not going to say who, but back in the day, they would make sure they had all the insurance on the rental car. So just in case they started shooting at each other, it was covered.
Sure.
And we would roll into an airport with the side of a car with 3 bullet holes and it's covered, you know.
Yeah.
Crazy. So, yes, there was a lot of trouble being made back in the day.
The most fun we got to do on that one is Craig T. Nelson was racing his Formula car there.
Yeah.
The guy that was the star of Coach, the TV show Coach. And we got to sit down with like a 20-minute interview with Craig T. Nelson. And we used about 3 or 4 minutes of it, but just shooting he was like engaging me, engaging Jim, and just telling stories. And it was a blast. It's so much fun. It's such a good guy.
We're in New Jersey. I first meet this group. I'm, I don't know, 25, 26, maybe 24 years old. I think my son was just born. We took lighter fluid to a brand new Mercedes SUV,
ooh,
lit it on fire, and then did laps with the car on fire. Yeah. Yeah, there's some issues there. All right, up next is the war memorial. So the 250th is done. There are some monies left over.
Yep.
The Civic Fund, a very fortunate Jim Putnam, who ran the 250th, is a vision guy like me. And we've decided to take, so we put some money back in towards the next 25 years or 50-year deal. Hopefully I'm not involved, but I'm maybe still alive. So we took extra money we had left over, and we're going to redo the town green where the war memorial is today.
Oh, very nice.
Which sits in the church there, right the crossroads of our New England, for me, Southwick. So Tynick Landscaping came up with some beautiful designs. Unfortunately, like you said, I'll send them to you, so maybe later you can put them on the YouTube or Channel 15.
Yeah, sure.
When I get out of here. So we're redesigning the whole thing. I met with the Lions Club last night. They're going to offer me 2 park benches, which I needed. Rotary Club in town they paid for 1 big Christmas tree, but just FYI, guys, you owe me for another tree because I'm putting 2 up. So I got to get some more money out of them guys. And I got a little bit of fundraising left on that deal to cover some sidewalk repair. The town's bringing water in. There'll be a couple fountains on the property when we're done.
Oh, very nice.
It's gorgeous. It looks like you're in D.C., it's going to come out real nice. The game plan, 2 weeks, we'll have water, hopefully, and then we'll start it. It'll be done for the fall for any services we do there in the fall. But
that's very cool.
Yeah, we call it the 100-year look back, right? Because we haven't touched that in 100 years. Technically, the church owns the property, and the town leases it and maintains it.
Okay.
So the nice part, I think, is I was involved with the last 2 monuments over there. A young man named Troy Hankey came. We started a project, God, it's got to be 5 years now, to update the war memorials. And I'd laughed because as a civilian trying to get information about people in wars, it's nothing but walls.
Yeah.
You know, but as a military guy, it's a different world. So me and Troy Hankey got together and basically I told Troy, I'll find the money to build these things, but I can't get anywhere when it comes to names.
Yeah, you can't put...
It's a nightmare.
Inscriptions on the stones.
Right. So Troy, the young man that he was at the time, he grabbed that with his military experience, and we've been a great team. He's helped out tremendously down there with, you know, we even have one up now. If you didn't leave out of Southwick, but when you were done with your services, you came to Southwick and you've been here X amount of years, we have a stone that you can go on there.
Oh, so, no kidding.
Yeah, which is rare, you know. Usually he goes right back to wherever you enlisted.
Right.
You know, so I could be in Chicago somewhere on a stone, I guess, right, if that's where I was out of.
Yep.
But, yeah, it's a big to-do. The new design is gorgeous, and hopefully it's, you know, I'm proud of it because, you know, I started the Civic Fund really to just give back to the town of Southwick. I was involved with Rotary for a million years, and they do a great job, don't get me wrong, but I think that was the place to join when I came back to Southwick, right? Lions or Rotary, and I knew the Foxes pretty well, Bobby, so I ended up with the Rotary, and then 1 year they didn't fund the fireworks that we were pushing for, and the Civic Fund was born. So we handle the Thanksgivings, we handle Christmas.
Yeah, you do a ton.
We do a ton, and I can't thank my crew enough. It's all good. So, yeah, we're short a couple $1,000. I'll be making the rounds and doing a little bit more begging to get that project up, done, and finished. And then that will bring us to my next project, which I didn't want to do. And then the other night, my team forced me to make a decision. So we're doing it. Fireworks. So we need to raise, I think we said $12,000, but I got the new bill. It's a little bit more. But I'll write a check for the difference. I don't care at this point. So the biggest issue is raising money, like it is everywhere. The town of Southwick does not pay for fireworks.
Right.
The select board in years past have donated. Park and Rec in years past have donated. So it is a community-involved project. Unfortunately, I see in Westfield there that Westfield, I guess there might be a little bit through Westfield and then a little bit through the Gas and Electric and Westfield Bank.
Yeah, they go to corporate sponsors too. Same thing, yeah.
Yeah, unfortunately in Southwick we only have a few big businesses in even during the 250th, the bigger ones didn't do anything. I don't know if it's because I was in charge or what, but it just didn't. Unfortunately, it made it a lot harder on certain people to raise money.
Sure.
And this is the same way. You know, quite honestly, I can't go back to any business. They helped me through the 250th. All the small mom and pop shops did, and I just couldn't see. You know, the economy today is running, and everyone's complaining. But the cost of goods today is through the roof. The cost of employees trying to maintain or keep employees is a struggle.
Oh, it's nuts.
It's nuts on every part of this. So you have to be, you know, as a business owner and as a fundraising guy, I have to walk a fine line because I know what they go through every day. I experience it every day. So I don't want to torture the businesses in town. So we came up with a program, real simple. We're 9,000 residents in town. So if... honestly, if 600 gave me $20 each, we're at the 12,000. Really simple. If 1,200 of us gave me $10 each, we're at the 12,000. And surprisingly, I think I've raised $500 in the last day through PayPal, whether they drop checks off at the Mulitius is where the Civic Fund is based out of. So there's a couple different ways to find.
Well, and the other thing is you're not a startup. People have seen results in the past. So that's
I'm not a startup. The money doesn't go anywhere but into what we do.
Right.
You know, it's still we did this so it wouldn't cost me as much money. But at the end of the year, every year I look and go, oh Jesus, I keep writing checks. What am I doing?
Well, yeah.
But that's what I do. That's what I am. So,
You need to find a college intern that's also a fundraiser.
Yeah, they tell me about that stuff. They really do.
I'll have you talk to Auerbach. He's got some connections in the local colleges.
But you know what's funny? At the end of the day, as much as people give money, a lot of people just want to talk to me. I don't know why. Maybe I have a way with my words that aren't the bad ones.
Well, maybe they can set up appointments with you, too. They can be like a...
I understand what you're saying.
I'll have you talk to Auerbach because he's got links at Western New England and Westfield State, so...
Yeah, and you're right. There's stuff out there. You just got to go after it, and you know, hopefully I can slow down a little bit now and go after it.
And that's an hour, my friend.
It is. Well, see, Pete, thanks for having me on. I appreciate the time. We had a couple great years together. And
your premier show is in the books for the Joe Didi Show, not the new show.
The Joe Didi Show. Oh, boy.
I got to take a picture of you so we can do a logo.
Yeah, do a logo.
I'm serious.
A cartoon character, right?
We'll get a caricature out, but I have an idea for a logo for you.
All right. Folks, thanks for having me. We'll see you next month.